You can't use information until you've checked that information. We recently worked on a project for the Ministry of Justice. Our role was to take these models and literally check them on a regular basis. So we really needed to make sure that the requirements aligned with our checking. And I think that connection between the two is very important. So we spent some time reorganising the requirements in order to then build the rules around. So we've got something now somewhere between 15,000 and 20,000 rules that we've built to check different concepts in the model and also different disciplines and different stages. So a lot of our rules come from a previous project we worked on. So we originally built those from scratch for that project. And they're built around their attribute requirements. So we're basically checking, for example, that fire rating exists in the model. But we're also, as part of our requirements documents, we set out that we required fire rating for different element types. So we would require fire rating for doors and beams and columns and so on. But we would then check that they were against the IFC schema. So were they in the right property set, essentially a folder? Were they in the correct location? So firstly, does the door fire rating property exist under PSET door common? But then secondly, also checking that the values in there are acceptable. So quite often you'll see that somebody might put 30, somebody might put 30 mins, somebody might put 30 mins in capitals, somebody might put 30 minutes and so on. So you have all these variables. So what we were very clear about in the requirements was that you're only allowed 30, 60, 90, 120 as values. So our model checking rules were built to check that those were the only values allowed, and then we would pass or fail on those criteria. So we were constantly checking models and then sending reports back in order to generate the requirements aligned with the Ministry of Justice's requirements. And then successfully delivered 16 federated models, fully checked with very, very few errors, and therefore the models were ready to be taken forwards and developed further. In terms of delivering projects and delivering quality projects, Solibri is invaluable in that process. And there are other tools that do geometry checking, there are other tools that do data checking. I think from our point of view, the fact that Solibri does both of those things, to us, extremely valuable. People think of geometry as being important on site, of course it is, but the data is also important when people are ordering things or doing accounts and installing things. And really, to the benefit is to remove those errors as early as possible and ultimately reduce cost by reducing the risk pot, really. So you're taking the risk away, and that can ultimately only benefit clients in the long run.